Yeah, sorry for that technical difficulties. I'm Eva. I'm a senior WordPress developer in CrowdFavorite. We create digital solutions for big enterprise companies. I love traveling. I love my WordPress sunglasses. And I definitely love WordCamp Europe. It's my favorite event. So lately, we had a project that had a requirement for importing data from external API. And in the beginning, we thought that we would have 5 endpoints. Like, we'll get data from 5 endpoints, we'll save it in WordPress, all good. But it turned out that they actually have 30,000 endpoints. And as you can imagine, it's a bit more complicated to do that. So what we like gonna ask now, why it's not timing out? Well, it was timing out. So what we ended up doing was automating it with custom commands with WPCLI, running on a cron job. Everything is getting imported in the background, and all is working well. What's WPCLI? It's a command line interface for WordPress. And the idea behind it is that you should be able to do the exact same things that you are doing in the WordPress admin via the commands in the terminal. If you follow the documentation and it has really good and detailed documentation, you'll be able to install it for a few minutes. And if you run WP, you'll be able to see the set of commands that are available for you. You have the command and short description. And you can do a number of things. You can update, because you always have to update. You can install plugins, themes, manage config files, and so on. So how exactly these commands are structured? We'll take a look at WP plugin install. As you can see, what you need to do is specify the plugin by a slug path or local zip file. And you also have a number of optional arguments. So you can specify version. You can say if you want to activate it immediately or not. And now, when you know how the commands look like, you probably are wondering how to create your own. So there are two main ways to do that. One is to create that in your WordPress plugin. And the other one is to set it up as a package for WPCLI. Packages for WPCLI are exact same thing like plugins for WordPress. So if you want to do that in your WordPress plugin, you have to first check if WPCLI is presented, and then write the code for your command. If you are doing it as a package, what you need to do is just run the WP scaffold package, which will generate all the files that you need, except the command itself. And actually, what is only required is that setup file with the information for your new command. What actually does the job is actually WPCLI add command. And the only thing that is required for it is the name for your command and a callback function. The callback function will actually do the whole job. And you can also add documentation with PHP doc for the future you and for your users. You can add short description, a long description that will be presented to your users when they run dash dash help on your command, and doc blocker comments. If you alternatively, you can do that adding a third argument in WP add command, like shown here. And you can add all the documents, like the short description and so on, inside the command. Of course, because everything should be tested, there is a Bihat framework for WPCLI, and it creates tests that are very easy to write. They are functional tests that interface with the command the exact same way that the users will do. So everything that's needed for that is to run WP scaffold package tests, which will generate files for your tests, and you're ready to go. So I think that I managed it for less than 10 minutes. You know how to create your new commands now. That's a simple example how you can create a command that will delete an option from the database. And you see the documentation above and callback function, name of the command. And it seems pretty easy, right? If you want to do a way more complex stuff with WPCLI, you need to dive in the internal API. There are a ton of handy functions, like you can handle errors, you can print success messages for your users, and way more that you can use in your commands to automate workflow and import data or whatever exactly you need to do with it. So that's it. I hope that it was interesting and that you actually tried. If there are questions, I'll be around all day, and my contacts are on the screen. Thank you.